Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy High School is dedicated to the formation of tomorrow's leaders through a Roman Catholic experience that provides excellence in atmosphere, academics, the arts, and athletics. Our vision is to be one of the most innovative, influential, and accomplished Roman Catholic schools in the nation.
Good morning. My name is Alexandra McNamee. Please stand for our prayer and Pledge of Allegiance. Today is December 10th, Tuesday of the second week of Advent. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord Jesus Christ, we recognize that you are the master teacher. You are the model for all educators because you lead all to the truth and the truth of yourself. No matter their subject area or academic specialty, inspire our teachers to both seek and proclaim your will, sharing the good news that you bring as they look for opportunities to draw students ever closer to you as your disciples. Since we cannot give what we do not have, enliven and encourage Catholic educators to teach with enthusiasm, zeal, and most importantly, with the virtues of faith, hope, and love. May they recognize that teachers are the most effective when they see the face of God in their students. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. Please turn to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Have a great day, Mavericks. Good morning and happy Tuesday, Mavs. I'm Alex McNamee.
And I'm Ashley Linares. Let's dive right into today's announcements.
Yes. Are you in the Christmas mood and do you feel like giving?
If you are, we have the perfect opportunity for you. Donate shoes to the Loving Souls Shoe Drive. All shoes will be donated to the Camila's house. We are trying to donate 600 pairs of shoes by December 11th.
Trust me, Mavs, we all have some extra shoes around the house. I myself have already pulled out 3 pairs to donate. And seniors, if you are applying to a school with a December 15th or January 15th deadline and are requesting your transcripts, you need to make those requests immediately.
It is also advised that you reach out to your teachers who still need to write your recommendations for those schools who require them and make sure they're uploaded as soon as possible. Tomorrow, December 11th, the dance team will be selling iced coffee and donuts to celebrate the end of the first semester and to help you get the caffeine kick to crush your midterms. Iced coffee is $2 and donuts are $1 and will be sold before school in the breezeway. Hope to see you there.
And the junior class SGA will be having a pizza sale tomorrow, December 11th, after school in the breezeway. Pizza will be sold for $2 a slice, so make sure you bring cash.
Today is our Advent Day of Reconciliation for our students. Father Jadot has invited several priests to join us to hear confessions throughout the day in the chapel. Students will attend today during their theology classes. Please come when you can to receive the grace of the Sacrament of Reconciliation.
And congratulations to the sophomores that got chosen to participate in the Hobie Conference. Hobie's mission is to inspire and develop our global community of youth and volunteers to a life dedicated to leadership, service, and innovation. And with that, Mavs, let's take things over to John Metzger in the Mavs Sports Zone.
What's up, Mavs? I'm John Metzger, back in the Mavs Sports Zone. Last night, the men's freshman basketball team played at home against St. Thomas. Then, the girls' varsity basketball team hosted Somerset Prep of North Lauderdale. Unfortunately, the team lost, dropping their record to 0-3. The team was led in scoring by junior Sophia Vigio, Ashley Green, Tori Welch, and Amaya Brookins-Gilly. The team returns to action next week when they go on the road to Slam Academy of Miami. Moving from the basketball court to the wrestling mat, the team recently competed and finished up in the top 10 with many first-timers in the lineup. It was a great start to the season and an awesome team-building weekend. Some highlights included Kevin Saldivar placing first in the consolation bracket, Lester Artigia coming in second, James Kalen placing second as well, and Michael Hernandez placing second as well. Jaden Villalobos played first in the championship bracket. Michael Gonzalez placed third. Reese Willenborg placed fourth. And Julio Rich placed sixth. Go Mavericks. This weekend, the equestrian team traveled to Plantation Equestrian Center to compete in the Heritage Horse Show. Allie Johnson placed second in her walk class, third in her walk/trot class, fifth in her trot class, and first in her walk/trot over fences class. In addition, Allie was also awarded reserve champion overall in her division. April Ahern placed fifth in her walk class, fourth in her walk and trot class, sixth in her trot class, and fifth in her walk and trot class over fences classes. Sabrina Sinkew placed second in her schooling equitation over fences class, second in her schooling hunter over fence class, and third in her schooling equitation on the flat class. And finally, Captain Valerie Servideo placed second in her schooling jumper over fences round, first in her schooling jumper speed round, and first in her schooling jumper classic round. In addition, Valerie was awarded grand champion overall for her division. That's it for today, Mavs. I'm John Metzger. See you next time in the Mavs Sports Zone.
Mavs on three! Mavs on three!
1, 2, 3, Mavs!
And thanks for that, John. So this weekend, Ashley and I felt a little holly and jolly.
And we know today's not Monday, but what better to bring it to you than Tuesday?
That's right, folks. Get ready for this Christmas episode of Adventures of Alex and Ashley.
Well, I never thought that it'd be so simple, but I found a way, I found a way.
Hey Mavs, on today's episode of Alex and Ashley, I'm going to be making a gingerbread house. What was that? Was that Alex?
Good morning Mavs, welcome to Mav News. I'm Alex Maxime. Today we're going to be making gingerbread houses. Let's get to it.
Hers is rainbow colors with rainbow decorations, and mine is a leftover from Halloween with orange icing, so just ignore that.
Tree, let the Christmas spirit ring.
I finished one side of my house. Alex is working on.
Let's go now.
With our icing choice. Hers is dripping. Oh no. Christmas. Hers is just a mess, okay? Look at that.
So Mavs, that's the end of a video, and that's the end of the adventures of Alex and Ashley for a little while. We hope you guys have an amazing Christmas break. So Merry Christmas from the both of us. And signing off, I'm Alex McNamee.
And I'm Ashley Linares. When we come back, we're going to have a special New Year's episode, so be ready.
Bye Mavs.
Thanks for watching, Mavericks. That was such a great episode, but we want to know, whose house do you think was better? So if you see us in the halls today, let us know. And now for this week's Tier List Tuesday, Alex, Gabe, and Aiden are going to be tier listing their top Star Wars movies.
So Alex, how was your Thanksgiving?
It was okay. It was
It's kind of boring, but it was nice.
Gabe?
It was traumatizing. What's up, Mavericks? Welcome back to Tier List Tuesdays. Today we're gonna be doing Star Wars, the movies. This is gonna be fun. We all like Star Wars, right?
Please don't attack us.
We're gonna be doing this in chronological order, by the way. So, episode 1, The Phantom Menace. It's a masterpiece, I think.
I don't know if I'd call it a masterpiece.
Jar Jar Binks, I think, is the best Star Wars character ever made. There's a thematic depth to his character.
You're asking for it, aren't you?
Episode 1's got the really cool lightsaber fight at the end. And I'm like a big Darth Maul guy. So I'd probably give it
all 5 seconds.
It does have Duel of the Fates, but that's like a 3-minute clip out of a 150-minute movie. It's not worth it.
Well, episode 2, Attack of the Clones.
Awful.
That's probably the worst Star Wars
My
movie.
My least favorite Star Wars movie.
It is really not good.
Not even close.
S tier.
Anakin Skywalker doesn't like sand. I don't like this movie.
Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. For me, like, especially out of the prequels, that's easily my favorite one.
I don't think it's a good movie, but again, out of the prequels, it's the watchable one for me.
It's like original trilogy levels of good. I love it.
Buddy! Buddy!
No.
Okay.
Solo, a Star Wars story. Attack of the Clones is like memorably awful, but Solo is just boring. I don't remember a single thing. Like, I can't criticize it properly here because I don't remember a single thing about it.
Chewie ripped some guy's arm off.
Okay, but like that happens in every Star Wars movie. Someone's arm falls off in every Star Wars
movie.
Oh,
yeah, but they don't get it ripped off.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's give it an A because they killed it.
Well, I think Solo gets it.
Rogue One. I enjoyed it definitely a lot more than Solo.
I think it's fine for what it is. Like, the final act is spectacular.
I mean, it's got its flaws, but for what it is, it's really good.
Episode 4, A New Hope.
This is where Star Wars gets good, everyone. Episode 4 is a masterpiece of cinematic filmmaking. If this film didn't exist, history would not be where we are right now, honestly, without this film. Cinema and the world.
Yeah.
Wait, we all like The Last Jedi?
Oh, you like The Last Jedi?
Yeah.
I mean, it was.
Wait, did
like
you actually? Yeah. Did you actually like it? Because I remember.
The film does suffer from a lot of issues, very off pacing, underdeveloped and annoying characters, plot twists that kill a lot of tension, lots of very convenient moments, and some unnecessary humor.
Gabe doesn't like Last Jedi. Empire Strikes Back.
This is the best Star Wars film.
This is the second best Star Wars film.
This is the Godfather 2 of the Star Wars franchise. No, I am your father. Like, where would cinema be without this?
Return of the Jedi.
The best Star Wars movie.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
So many movies worth of buildup. Luke knowing he's gonna face his dad and the Emperor.
Cool, that happens in the last 20 minutes of the film. The first 100 is them doing stupid stuff on Endor.
And all the stuff with Endor, I thought it was awesome.
I don't like it.
But
I don't like
Ewoks.
It's episode 7, Force Awakens.
No, I love Force Awakens. It just didn't feel that original.
There's just something so infectious about it.
Episode 8, The Last Jedi.
I feel like a lot of the reaction to The Last Jedi was just like a competition to see who would hate The Last Jedi the most.
Kylo Ren's easily my favorite character.
I can step back from this. I won't give a personal favorite this time. I've won too many times. How should we settle this?
We will settle this in a classic duel.
First one to drop their expo marker loses. You may commence.
What are we doing? Hey!
I guess Alex won.
Wow, what an amazing episode of Tier List Tuesday.
So great.
And now for some breaking news, Mavs. Here is a great chance to earn service hours for donating gift cards. Super easy. Donate to the Schroeder Memorial Golf Classic and get 2 volunteer hours for every $25 gift card. You can donate gift cards to a coffee house, Publix, Walmart, Macy's, any other restaurants, or event tickets. And you will get 2 volunteer hours. Drop off your donations at the front office in an envelope or bag with the word golf, your name, and grade outside of it. And with that, today for lunch, the cafeteria is serving up some lentil soup, a beef taco bowl with sour cream, lettuce, salsa, chips, and roasted corn. And with that, I'm Alex McNamee.
And I'm Ashley Linares. Have a terrific Tuesday, Mavs.